Hello everyone, today I am going to discuss computing with numbers in Python. First, what is numeric data types? What is data types and what is numeric data types? When computers were first developed, they were seen primarily as a number crunchers. And that is still an important application. As you have seen, problems that involve mathematical formulas are easy to translate into Python programs. The information that is stored and manipulated by computer programs is generally referred to as data. Different kinds of data will be stored and manipulated in different ways. Two different types of data are integer data type. What is that integer data type? Whole numbers are represented using the integer data type. In short, we will call it as int. Values of type int can be positive or negative, but should be whole numbers. Example, 5, 3, minus 4, minus 6 is on. Second, floating point values. Numbers that can have fractional parts are represented as float data type. Example, .25, 10.99, .01, fractional numbers. Python provides a special function called type that tells us to data type of any value. See here, type. Which data we are finding? Which data type? 3 is int type. Next, type float type. I want to find the float type. 3.14 I will give. After pressing enter, class is float type. Float data type. Like this, we can check the which data type the number is. Again, float type. Next, my int is equal to minus 32. I initialize minus 32 to my int. Then what is the value my int? Minus 32. Which type this one? So I have to execute type my int. Then minus 32 is the int type. Next, float type. Type suppose if I give type my float, like this is the error message. Means name my float is not defined. No values inside the my float. So it gives the error. So your procedure is my float is equal to like this. What we given first, no? Like this, so you have to check float type constantly. Next, what are the operations we are doing? See here, plus, addition, minus, plus, float type plus, we are getting the float type answer. And int type means int answer we will get. 3 plus 4, 7. Next, one float type. Another float type. Next operation is division. Float type division, we are getting the output in float type. here intertype division also we are getting the same value. There is no difference. See this one, 10 module, this one is percent sign is the module 3. We are getting the output remainder 10 divided by 3, then remainder is 1. Next last one is ABS to calculate the absolute value. Absolute value of minus 3.5 is 3.5. Using the math library, besides plus, minus, into, division, exponential, remainder, absolute value, Python provides many other useful mathematical functions in special math library. A library is just a module that contains some useful definition. Example, a program makes use of square root function. There we will use the SQRT. To use this library function, we have to write import math. Means Python tells the Python that we are using the math module. Some of the functions that are available in the math library given below, read it. See here, our library file name is math.py. We are importing the math library, import math. Our radius value is 2. Then I am printing the area of circle with a radius of 2. See, our math is the library file connecting to the, we are taking the PI value from math library, then into, then our calculation radius exponent 2. After that executing this, we are getting the value area of the circle with the radius 2. This is the area of the circle, 12.56. Accumulating results. What is that accumulating result and what is that factorial? How we are accumulate result in factorial function? See, suppose you have 6 different sweets. Eating the various flavor in different order might affect how good they taste. If you wanted to try out every possible ordering, how many different orders would there be? Answer is 720. Do you know where is this number comes from? The value 720 is the factorial of 6. In mathematics, factorial is often denoted with the exclamation sign. N factorial is equal to, formula is like this, N into N minus 1 into N minus 2, like this going on. Suppose our example is 6 sweets, then 6 factorial is equal to 6 into 5, 30. Then we take the result 30 and do another 30 into 4, 120. Next we take the result 120, 120 into 3, 360. After 3, 2, 360 into 2, 720. After 2, 1, 720 into 1, 720. We are doing repeated multiplication and as we go along, we keep track of the running product. This is very common algorithm pattern called accumulator. To accomplish this in program, we will use the accumulator variable and loop structure. The general pattern look like this. To initialize the variable, fact is our variable, fact is equal to 1. we are initializing one to fact. Okay, next, we already studied loop statement, how it works. Loop until final result is reached means our last number is 6. We have to give the loop statement. I discussed clearly in my previous video. Update the value of accumulator. Our accumulator variable name is fact. Then we have to change the fact value. How to get fact into factor? Okay, 6 into 5 in first iteration. Like this is going on. This is a factorial program to compute the factorial of numbers. What it tells in this program, we will study for loop with accumulator. We are taking n variable and n type is int type. We have to input the n value, so input statement we have to give. You should give the whole number because this one is the factorial program. Then I initialize fact to 1. Next, we have to give the loop to calculate the factorial. For factor, factor is the variable name. In range, n value is now, suppose our sweets are 6, n value is 6, suppose I am taking the value 6. 6, after that 1 increment you have to do, every time, every iteration minus 1 you have to do to n, up to all numbers you have to take from for loop. 6, 5, 4, like this. Okay. Fact is equal to fact into factor. Our first fact value is 1, then into after factor value. Next, 6 into 1, after that 6 into 5, 5 into 4, like this going on in these two statement. After that we will get the output 720. This is the logic to find factorial.